Hi everyone, a little quick info before the episode starts. For some reason, in this episode, the quality is a little bit bad. OBS has been doing some updates, my settings are a little bit messed up. I didn't notice it until right now when starting editing this episode and two more episodes. The good thing is I didn't go that far into the story, so we don't see any drastic thing happening, but the quality is going to be bad for episode 2, 3, and 4. So I'm really sorry about that, and I hope you at least enjoy the episode in some way. Hey everyone, and welcome back to more Life is Strange. Before the Storm, Remastered. Last time we went to a quite awesome concert, and some stuff happened. You know, sketchy dudes, drug dealers, rock and roll, and now we're back here in our bedroom, and we need to change clothes because we smell like cigarettes and shit.
I still smell like last night. I really need to change.
Basically what she says, but we are going to look around. So let's look around.
I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually. I'd like to think my humor has improved with age.
You can improve it.
Better living through chemistry. That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real?
For those who haven't played Life is Strange, the first game, here's a couple of names here you can recognize. Warren Graham, Chloe Price, of course, Hayden, Zachary, Trevor, Logan, Alyssa, Justin, Elliot, Dana, Amos. Yeah, mostly every one of them. Cool.
One of these days I'm actually going to use you to do my homework.
Or you can just surf the web.
Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
Ask Miss Arcadia, okay. Dear Miss Arcadia, did you hear about Firewall coming to town? Checked all the local venues, but nobody knows anything. Sergey 22. Could that be Sergey? I think that's not called Sergey. Oh, those local venues apparently don't know about bumping the Fred. Okay, gents, here's the scoop. It's a private party. Not as in you're not invited. More like, you better off staying away. And I know that just made some of you more into it than ever. To proceed at your own risk / abandon, all I hope is that all you who enter ever heard of the mill. Thanks for scoop. Oh shit, if you go, don't look anybody in the eyes. If you look anybody in the eyes, don't look away. If you look away, then you listen to the advice now. Look at my eyes. My eyes are alien. Great movie. The Doctor. That is Warren. That is still Warren. What are you talking about? Not of this earth. Only the original, though. Is that a Doctor Who reference? Because there's a thing that the Doctor does, like, I am the Doctor. The original, you might say. Is that kind of reference? That's adorable. Could that be, what's her name? The girl with the glasses. Okay, I can remember in a second. Prescott's and the Illuminati.
Wait, what? Who? What photo?
2. Chloe Price. Subject, Victoria Chase commented on a photo you're tagged in. To view the photo, make sure you click on the following link. Is that a real link? I'm gonna check that out. Okay, I just checked. It's not a real site.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
Took a selfie. Rachel, Firewall, Trevor, jealous. Victoria, you look hot. Who's the arm candy? Armand, Deborah something. Deborah Borgen, I think. Taylor, so funny. Kisses. Dina, glam. Get it, girl. Trevor, who's Deborah Borgen? Armand, with Rachel in the picture. Juliet, ugh. Rage, you're so gorgeous. I hate you. XOXO. Victoria, and who's Armand? Dude. Trevor, dude, that's Chloe Price. Should I read the names? Okay, I'm not gonna read the names. Taylor, wasn't Rachel invited to your sleepover last night? I was wondering where she was. Burn. Oh no, I didn't mean it like that. So much fun. This is a really intelligent conversation. So, Rachel Amber was invited to a sleepover, but said F it and went to Firewalk instead.
Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
Like, these little details are stuff like I don't remember at all from playing this last time. So it's very interesting to actually read more into it.
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear.
Mr. Shark.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
Funny.
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Ooh.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
I saved all of these. You have to delete that photo of me dancing. Only you could get me to loosen up like that. Happy 2 month anniversary, Elliot. That's the tickets. Nice.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
That's another band? I guess. Skateboard!
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
And I guess you can train a little bit, doing, you know, leg day.
Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look.
Oh, she definitely gonna complain.
I bet long Matt Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago. How do I want to express my teenage angst today?
Well, we just have to check and see. Oh shit, I didn't mean to click that. God damn it. I was gonna say, since this is the remastered, I have all the DLC. But that's the Raven look. That's built. Okay. I'll check all of them out. Butterfly. I had a Firewalk shirt. Could potentially wear that one because we did get it at the place. I'm actually considering it. But let's check out the bonus outfits. Chloe Classic. I'm thinking that would be her jacket and hat. Beanie. Not a beanie. What do you call it? Yeah, it's the classic one. That feels so off, she's not having the blue here.
Speaking of Firewalk, heard it through the grapevine they had an impromptu concert on the edge of town last night.
If you were there, so strange.
I'd love to hear from you. Give me a call. Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting his doors.
Might have something to do with dog man. Green hoodie, nice. Hot Dog Man is just iconic in the whole Life is Strange universe, so cool. Illuminati. Illuminati. A punk dough. I guess that's just the normal dough on it. Jane Doe. Obviously, that kind of looks too kid-like. To be honest. That's all up. Okay, I'm gonna... Let's do Firewalk. Because we did go to the Firewalk concert. So why not? That'd be cool. Yeah. I'll go with that.
I really should get going.
Okay, let's go.
Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with mom's.
87.9 FM, the Seder, supported by listeners like...
That is a thing you can do.
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Classic Chloe house. Bathroom? Hi. It's nice when in video games you have a proper mirror. Although, AAA games have problems with it. I know Cyberpunk had one, but it was so goddamn laggy. This is more of a... I want to say it's an indie game, but it's not really an indie game anymore. But it's still nice having a proper mirror.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay.
I kind of thought of a thing when she was...
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
Wait, I love how she says it, but kind of follow a funny thing with that joke about the tower. Now, when we were changing clothes and had the Illuminati shirt, I kind of thought Illuminati. Like, it sounds so funny, but I thought of it in my head, Illuminati.
Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Where in America is Arcadia Bay? No idea, but it's outside. We can see a little bit of Arcadia Bay. Kind of wood grocery outside. Little pictures, probably a grandma. That's something. It's her mom's room.
I think mom's phone is in her bedroom.
And she's right there.
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign.
Well, it's good. It's good to make your bed.
I want mom to be happy, but not like this. Not like this!
Love after loss, a guide to forgiving oneself and moving forward. Can read a little bit of it.
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower thing. Than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech.
I can actually agree.
Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better.
I can agree with those, especially the first one. Things need to happen for something to change. I know that for experience. In a way, but yeah, I can agree with that. So don't spew that, Chloe. It might just not be that you don't like your stepdad, but yeah. What does she have in the drawer?
It's weird that mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Like one of those buying catalogs. Yeah, I actually have not seen one of those in a long, long time. Here in Sweden, at least. Ooh, condoms.
Mom.
Ooh.
Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Is there anything else?
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
Well, we're gonna play something to draw. May David...
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
May clothes that never be forgotten. I kind of thought that was a bong. Another conversation thing. Necklace.
I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Arcadia Pond, a perishable instant cash. Diamond ring, near colorless. Grade B, insurance value 1,200. Cash value 300. Store credit value 500. Only an estimate. Offer not guaranteed. Oh, she's still in the ring. Conversation thing we can have right there. Okay, let's call our phone.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Totally agree. Okay, here we go.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
In the bathroom? Oh.
Ugh. I drank way too much last night. Or was it just enough?
Oh.
There we go.
Oh, the reason why it would be next to the toilet. We have a couple of messages. Let's read Mom. Will you be joining us for supper? No thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Chloe, will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences. Reminds me of my tattoo on my arm. Insert picture here. Let's see. Elliot, I can scroll all the way up. Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Aw. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Okay, you finished the chem homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. I already know everything. Frank! Your shit's here. Hell yeah. But tapped out, your loss. Hey, you can hold it for me a day, can I? I'm your favorite customer, are you? Frank, you're holding? You're still, oh, you're gonna have me whacked. Yes, please joke about that over text. Your deal drugs on your phone. Anyway, calm on, it's 420. I'll meet you if you have the cash. Rain check. Max, oh god. I'm so sorry, I've been bad at emailing, texting is better for me anyway. Yo, it's Max. How's it going? You there? Sorry again, I've been really busy. I love Seattle. More in a bit. Cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future? Hey, hippie. I'm so sorry, but maybe you should set up a time to call. No worries. I'll check my dance card. It's 7 PM in Arcadia Bay. What is it? 2019 in Seattle? I know, right? Maybe this weekend. Sure, anytime. Let me know. Yo, Queen of the Crickets. What's the latest, Max? That's so sad.
Breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
We were just looking at the purse.
Saw Mom's purse in her room?
We were looking at it. You have a quiet purse. Oh god, greedy mom!
I need to talk to you.
Oh god, we're in danger.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
I remember in the first... Oh yeah, there's still a transition with this. I don't understand why there should be a transition.
Coming, mom.
No idea why.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Well, let's explore this place. Look.
David's here so early. Mom calls him just a friend, but look at him. He's pretending he didn't just spend the night. And you never saw the condoms, Chloe. You never saw the condoms. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Hi, Mom.
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food. Joyce Price, aka Mom. She looks as beat as I feel.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget.
I'm not gonna forget.
Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast.
I actually would like some pot roast. It's been way too long since I had that. My mom doesn't like pot roast too. Late to her mom.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth?
I'd rather have granola.
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
But how is travel money? Eesh. Is that outside his offense? Ooh, loans!
Mom's purse is pretty heavy.
Are you complaining?
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole.
May 7, 2010, Friday. Shipyard closing. The real estate developer Sean Prescott promised that the employee layoff would be minimal when he purchased the shipyard. He announced this week he will be ending operations effective immediately. In a move not surprising to longtime residents of the region, the Prescott Foundation also liquidated the Arcadia-based Steve Doors Association. No idea what that is. The defined pension plan. Okay. I'm gonna read all that. Michelle Kinsey Robertson, staff attorney for the foundation, defended the action as our right in recouping unrecovered losses against the debts owned. Sean Prescott would not be reached at the for a comment. Nice.
Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
A wildlife warning has been issued for all the residents of Arcadia Bay. Fines double for illegal fireworks and campfires in unauthorized areas. Yeesh.
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Oh, Arcadia Bay, get set. Titillian hike. Let me be emphatic. This is not due to financial woes, says Principal Ray Wells. After a survey of the tuitions of prestigious academics of similar caliber, we're simply keeping ourselves competitive. Blackwell parents invest in their children, not their vacation homes. Wells Fudor emphasized that additional to merit-based tuition awards, this year won by sophomores? What the fuck is that? Stella Hill and Brooke Scott, the school's program for need-based scholarships remains in place for students who maintain exceptional academic records. These words. What the hell? I don't know those. I'm sorry.
Feeling trapped? Right there with you.
Well, it's a deer, so how dare you say that? Bad joke.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Oh, it probably has a headache. Let's see, what's this, ashtray?
I made that for mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Wait, those aren't mom's keys.
And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made mom. Like his home, maybe?
Can we take them and throw them away? Funny thing, actually. When I was younger, I made an ashtray for my parents. Because when I was a kid, they both smoked. They don't smoke now, but they did. I made an ashtray. They never used it as an ashtray. Well, it might be good since it stopped, but
it's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so nobody's fault, really. From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
Yes, years later.
Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one.
Old school TV.
Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this
bad boy.
We're
already supporting one. Thanks.
Sorry.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back?
Rash?
Mom doesn't want me to know. But it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Well, he's a vet. No ill offense to all the vets, but work is important.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Well, she doesn't go to Blackwell anymore. Okay, purse.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Hi, Mom.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Do I want noisy? Do I want to be pretty or nice? Well, she obviously likes her mom, but not the way she's too over the top on her. So I could be a little bit nice, but also a little bit snarky.
I was sleeping. I didn't get your text until just now.
Oh, you make it so hard to trust you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse, then? Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah.
I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewall? I didn't laugh.
Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that-
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled?
Oh, yeah, she's not expelled.
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But, Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Okay, this is one of the big choices. Do I be understanding or say what I feel? He hates David. No joke about that. But there's a lot of pressure on her mom. What would she do? I honestly could think that she could probably be nice to her mom and still be a dick to David. That's what I have think in my mind. So I'm gonna choose to be understanding.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient.
This is the right one.
Not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.